Hello, everyone, and welcome. You are about to hear and see a story. A story about a man that some people say is a legend. Well, I don't know about that. You see, this story is about me. I'm not entirely sure I'm a legend. I just lived my life the only way I knew how to live it. With joy. Oh, and determination, perseverance, and love for my family, friends, and students. I am Clarence DeMar, and this is my story.
Well, very good then. All right. Ding,
Appian Way. I don't really think it's me that is being honored, rather the love I had for running. The fact that running is for anyone. Everyone is welcome to train and plan and step up to the starting line. Take this person, for example. She is on her very own journey. I don't know what it is, but it's hers. Whatever goal she has set for herself, she will have to dig deep. She will have to believe that she is unstoppable.
Say what they want now.
times in my life I needed to believe I was unstoppable. In 1910, I ran the Boston Marathon. I came in second. In 1911, just before I was about to run, race doctors listened to my heart. They informed me that I had a murmur. They advised me to drop out if I was feeling fatigued. They told me that this should be the last race that I run. Now, with all due respect to the medical community, I needed to listen to my own body and decide what it was telling me I should or shouldn't do. I felt strong, so I ran. I ran with joy. And you know what? I won it.
Reluctantly crouched at the starting line, engines pumping and thumping in time, the green light flashes, the flags go up, churning and burning, they yearn for the cup. They deftly maneuver and muscle for rank, burning fast on an empty tank. Reckless and wild, they pour through the turns, their prowess is potent and secretly stern. As they speed through the finish, the flags go down, the fans get up and they get out of town. The arena is empty except for one man, still driving and striving as fast as he can. The sun has gone down and the moon has come up, and long ago somebody left with the cup. But he's driving and striving and hugging the turns and thinking of someone for whom he still burns. And he's going the distance. He's got no speed. She's all alone in a time of need. Because he's racing and racing and riding the course. He's riding and riding and riding on his horse. He's going the distance.
Boston Marathon 7 times. I bronze medaled in the 1924 Paris Olympics. Now that was something. Our fair city of Keene even threw me a parade. But sometimes in life, your mind starts playing tricks on you. You start to tell yourself terrible things. Things like, you're going to fail. People will laugh at you. You aren't strong enough or fast enough. If that's what you say to yourself, that is exactly what you will begin to believe. Now, if you say something else, if you say something kind or nice to yourself, you will start to believe that. Yep, it's that easy. I've asked my mind and body to do extraordinary things. Whenever I was feeling particularly challenged, I would say something helpful. I would tell myself to never give up.
cousin Clarence lived and breathed his mantra, never give up, every day of his life. He became a legend in the running community. At the age of 49, he finished seventh at Boston. At 54, he still placed in the top 20. At 61, in the top 45. In his final Boston Marathon run in 1954, my 65-year-old husband still ran in under 4 hours. He was 69 when he ran his last race, but he was unwell. His time to leave this earth had come, but his determination and joy for life never failed. Just a day or so before he left us, he did something remarkable, perhaps more remarkable than all the running and race winning. Determined to leave behind something beautiful, Clarence crawled out of bed into the backyard and planted a garden. He simply refused to give up.
Story. What will they say was my purpose for running? I did it for fame or glory? For the win? I hope not. I ran because it brought me joy. When they write my story, who are they anyway? Who is writing this story? She could only possibly possess some vague understanding of my story. It is more likely that she has made some connection between her own story and mine. So, what is her story? How did she get to the starting line? How did she train to cross the finish line? Currently, there are hundreds of people training for my namesake race on September 29th. Some are over 70. Some are barely 7. Each of them is looking to meet a goal that's been set. Each is looking to say at sundown on September 29th, I am a champion.
I'm a champion. You'll be looking up at me when it's over. I live. the courage I possess through the trauma. H is for the hurt, but it's all for the honor. A is for my attitude, working through the patience. Money comes and goes, so the M is for motivation. Gotta stay consistent, the P is to persevere. The I is for integrity, innovative career. The O is optimistic, open and never shut. And the N is necessary, cause I'm never gonna.